Pixel. I think it's recording doing that. We just bought the same, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got to play with it, huh?
Oh, yeah. Start over again, so that's sign, guys. Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco.
Wait.
You gonna film all the way across now?
I think we're close enough yet, are we?
Either in about less than 5 minutes.
No, I'm not gonna take an hour now. That's boring.
Does it say record?
Isn't it, Daddy? No, it says standby.
Okay.
I made a mistake again.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, it says record. We should have gone up to that, remember that place we got lost in the mountains?
Oh, yeah.
In the mountains.
Yeah. climbing really high now. If you put the camera back, you'll see how high up in the air we are now. We're off to the side there. You can see the angle.
Oh, yeah. That's great.
Just keep filming because we're coming up to the Bay Bridge or to the Golden Gate now.
I don't want any comments about us filming after.
There's the Golden Gate Bridge, guys. Look.
Look.
See it.
It's a shame because today is a bit cloudy and it's been so lovely and sunny up until today. It still looks pretty.
It does, doesn't it? Just to left that big pyramid building.
Ooh. And Auntie Sarah used to live over there.
Yep. But put back over here where we're at on the bridge now.
Woohoo!
By the way, your mom just had a whole pitcher of margaritas.
I'm just kidding. Poor daddy corrects me.
This is the Golden Gate Bridge.
Oh, is that what it is?
Bay Bridge is over there. Look, point to the Bay Bridge, Rachel. Can you zoom in on it? It's a bit windy on the Golden Gate tonight.
Daddy almost said bay.
Yeah, almost did.
Uh-huh.
No, I was going to say windy on the bay.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Oh, it does look pretty there.
It does, doesn't it?
Pretty. I'm missing it, actually, staring through the telly monitor.
Car.
That's okay. I know who rented it,
man.
It's okay. I'm
fine. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Didn't have to say anything. She did it all for us.
She did. So, children, that was the Golden Gate Bridge. What a ride. And look, Daddy is still here to tell the story.
Hi, guys. Your mom's had a lot of margaritas. Margaritas tonight. I sound like I've had quite
Why do you have to keep saying that?
Because she's...
You're tainting the video.
I'm not tainting the video.
You are.
I'm just putting everything in perspective. Look, kids, see San Francisco right in front of us. Look at this, guys. Isn't that cool? Beautiful city, guys.
I'm not taping the city. I'm taping the dash door.
You're taking.
I'm taping the dash door.
Off to the rest of the Presidio. It's kind of boring.
Oh, yeah. You're right, it is boring. It's pretty, though. Pretty. Shall we switch off now?
Yeah.
I'm gonna be all face and spot.
I am to have you.
Really?
Sometimes improvisation is a means for survival. Well, sir, it's clear that we should go in this direction.
Gentlemen, I think we should go in the other direction.
Exactly. If you go in that direction, then eventually you come around to going this direction. So actually, now that we agree.
And sometimes improvisation leads to greatness.
What say you to that, Mr. Henry?
I say, give me liberty.
Woo-hoo!
Give me, or give me no mutton for at least 2 weeks. I mean, give me liberty or give me death.
Yeah! Bass recognizes man's gift for improvisation by sponsoring the Bass Red Triangle Company.
Hey guys, we're going to go through this tunnel. When we come out of the tunnel, we're going to be in Chinatown.
Whatever your passion is, reach for greatness. And if you don't have one, well, improvise. Bass, reach for greatness. Imported by Bass Importers.
Which is where the Chinese dinner set that Grandma and Grandpa bought us was bought from.
As yourself and company, which is also in the future.
After Daddy and I got married.
Francisco.
Yeah. Or the show that Ainsley likes. Ugh, what's that one? One with Cameron Diaz. Children don't look. There's a strip parlor or something over there.
Where?
There.
Oh yeah.
The sweetest thing. That's in San Francisco.
That's right.
Yeah. Walking up and down the hills.
Film behind us, you can see how steep the hill is behind us. Man, we'll stick it up out of the sunroof and show.
No, we can see it.
Can you see all the way up it?
Yep.
Oh, cool.
The children will be thrilled.
Yes, they will.
Davis.
That's right.
Or you can try Font, I think the other one is. Is it Font?
I'm not sure which one it was.
Oh, hello. Oh God, I'm like every other tourist.
Well, guess what, Ainsley? We'll get there with about 20 minutes to spare, 15 minutes to spare before Friends comes on.
Oh yeah, it's Thursday night, we're flying out tomorrow, but the final of Friends is on, we're going back to the hotel to watch. Now shut you off for a moment till we get closer to the hotel. We've just pulled onto the road where our hotel is, just to give you a little bit of insight.
Is it really on this road?
No.
What's in
you need
this
to go
area?
Down to the left.
Left area. That's right.
Left then right. This we're actually going to erase.
How much what?
How much of this film we're going to erase?
Oh, I know. This dude needs to pick a lane. Oh, we're coming into the hotel, guys.
Oh, look, there's a man just walking out in front of us. Oh, we almost had that on record.
See, the look he was giving me. That would have been America's Funniest Videos.
Now what are we going to do with the car, Daddy?
I'm going to get a ticket for the guy to park it.
Isn't that cool?
And here we are.
Ta-da!
So we are done.
You filming?
Yep.
I'm going to film like a special card. No?
Oh yeah, special card for the elevator. You have to wait till the light flickers.
Atrium.
Put it in till the light flickers, Rachel. Now pull down. Now push it.
You going down or up?
We're going up.
This one's going down, it's good.
Here, give me the card.
It's fine.
Mm.
We'll go down, we'll go back up.
Okay.
Thank you.
Can you do that? Okay. Morgan, show's 10 minutes away.
Yeah, just a pair of shorts on.
Something
with
more room after that dinner.
Floor 6, going up. Floor 14, going up.
So, I am now, this is our room, guys. It's a view from outside. This is the view inside. It's looking straight down. There's mommy up there. Say hi, mom. So there's 1612 inside the room. This is the view from outside. Bay Bridge is just right there. Across the bay is Oakland. That's way over there. It's the East Bay. Went to a game last night over probably about there in that general direction. 12 miles away or so. This is the view of the marina with the pier. There's a restaurant over there. Went over there the other night. We didn't eat though because it looked way too expensive. Sinbad's. And we open it up here like so. We do the latch, which is right here. We open up like so. Voila. Our balcony. Of course, there's a view of the street. Straight down. And up. And around. It's downtown San Francisco.
She threw my hand to say, Daddy's asleep. Isn't it pretty? I've seen them all. Thank you. Bring the doorbell.
Is that me?
Hello, yeah. Come in.
The usual thing to do on this kind of occasion is to be present at this place. To give a long talk about something I know about and that I often do, which is language. I'm going to play with a few words for you here. I hope they'll make some, help get some meaning into what we're doing here at the Mexican Address. And here are the words. Curriculum, grades, see this theme here. Curriculum, grades, graduation, degree, associate, bachelor, master, and commencing. I'm an English teacher. I talk about words. I talk about the history of words and what they can make to mean. So I hope I can make this interesting for us all to go through. Here are the words. Curriculum. That's what we did to get this degree, right? Curriculum is, of course, what you say. Now that comes from, it's actually a Latin word, and it means a racing chariot. And sometimes it has to do with, you know, the Colosseum, and you race around and run around. Sometimes that's just what you think it seems to be, just running around the circle. Curriculum also means the course and around the racing track. But you're not just going round and around in a circle or an oval. There's a finish. information line. As Chaplin mentioned, using St. Paul's in running the race, this is the finishing line. It was a racing charity curriculum that led you up to this point. And here, some stuff to celebrate where you are right now. The root of the word curriculum is basically the word for run. So the curriculum that you went through in your studies was meant to keep you running. You know, it's not something you just sort of saunter through. You run through it. And a lot of you are sitting here now, catching your breath. Great. You know, I was thinking, I always think about that word. I don't think so are you. What grade am I going to give? And then I give a grade and I get beta back and forth. But what does a grade mean? It comes from a Latin word that means a step. It's a step. First it meant the kind of grade of the degree you get, like you get a cum laude or something like that. Later it meant the grade you get on a paper, like an A minus or a B plus. But basically it means a step, where you are at the moment. What step are you on? Like a ladder. What step is a ladder? Flight of stairs. What is that here? Not quite up. No. There's also that phrase, make the grade. The other thing is, it doesn't come from the same thing. It's got a different route, and it refers to the railroads, and the grade is a sort of inclining slope that they have to build from the railway to go up a hill. The image there is a little engine that could. The little engine that could didn't give up. It went up the hill, and it made the grade. It got to the top. So in that sense, your grade is valid. It is not there something you receive or say, okay, that's my grade. It is a challenge for you to achieve. Graduation. That also comes from the same word as grade. It means a step. Maybe it's the sense of stepping up. What are you going to do soon? They're going to call your name. You're going to come here. Step. Yeah, graduate. And a degree. You get a degree. Now that actually comes from the same word. Through the French, they want to change things around. And the word clay, G-R-E, means degree. There's lots of different meanings of the word degree. First degree burn, but that's not what it's like. Originally, a degree meant the preliminary steps to getting a master's degree or a doctorate. That is to say, your degree was a bachelor's degree. That means you're on your way. Later on, they let master's degrees be called degrees too. I guess technically a PhD is not a degree. Therefore, your AA degree, your BA, your BSc, these are just steps on the way towards qualification or something. Maybe we'll get to that, I'm not sure. It's also taken from this idea of the medieval guilds, which, like the Masons, had various degrees or steps by which a person qualified. In the military, you've got ranks. That's the same sort of thing. But, you know, when you become a sergeant, you're not qualifying to become, you know, a higher rank. You're just taking on other duties. But the sense of it in the academic sense, and in the sense of the guilds, you begin at a certain place and you work your way up. There's no point beginning if you don't work your way all the way up. You start as an apprentice, serving your time. You take a test. You show that you have the skill to be a silversmith or a woodcarver. You achieve the next degree. And finally you get a license to practice your trade. Now, what kind of degrees are we talking about? There's an associate degree. What's an associate degree? It comes from the word socius, which means an ally. An associate degree is a associate is someone who is united to the cause, who is an ally in university endeavor. I suppose before that, you're looked on with some suspicion. Is he going to make it? Is she going to make it or not? Okay, you made it to the AA. UK. You're part of us now. Maybe no one's ever thought about it like that, but we are. Bachelor. No one really knows for sure where the word came from. But there is a word that in the Middle Ages referring to farmhands. The guy who herds the cows was called a bacalaureus, a bachelor. More to the point, a bachelor is the term in chivalry. A bachelor is, some of you may know this, it's a young knight. Not old enough, or not rich enough in having vassals, to have his own banner. So if you're going out to fight, the knight has his banner and the senior on his shield. The bachelor knight just comes on behind without any markings, follows somebody else, a novice in arms. In the guild system, a bachelor was a junior member or a yeoman of the guild. And in academic senses, a bachelor is one who's taken the first or lowest degree of the university, who's not yet a master of arts. We say, wait a minute, what about associates? Isn't that the first degree? But that's a relatively recent degree. There's also a sense that, baccalaureus is the Latin version of this, and some people hold that baccalaureus means the laurel berry, the berries of a laurel. You're a bachelor, you can go out and see a laurel bush and say, I take a little sprig and wear that to show that you're a bachelor. You don't think that's the real word. You can play like this. Only later on did a bachelor come to mean an unmarried man. As a student was saying in class last night, there's also the word bachelorette. Bachelorette, pardon? But that doesn't apply in academics. You don't have a bachelor degree for the men and a bachelorette degree for the women. That would be interesting, but we're not doing it. It's a master's degree. It comes from the Latin word magister, which means a teacher. With a master's degree, you are qualified to teach. It's also related to the word minister. And also related to the word maestro. Maestro. Master. The expert. A master's degree has proved to have mastered the material, to be proficient enough to practice it, to use it without supervision. That's important. Traditionally, a master's degree was what was required to go off and teach at the university. Now it's often a PhD required. That's just an invention. And the word commencement. It works its way up in the Italian word cominciamento, which comes from the Latin word, which basically is initiate. Initiate. We know how to use the word commence. He commenced to do it. He began to do it. Commencement means a beginning. You come here to commencement day, and the whole celebration is the end of this long curriculum, this long race course. But the word reminds us that it's not the end, it's the beginning. It's almost like here you are, and you're turning around to look at the past, and what we've all done, and there's somebody who turns you back to the front and says, hold on, son, you're facing this way. And the commencement reminds you that's where we're going. It's the same thing as in, I'm really not going to bore you with this, but there's a very obscure tense, past tense, in the Greek language. And it's the tense that John the Evangelist uses, giving us the last words of Christ on the cross. And he says, it is finished. Tetelestai. It is finished. What that means in the Greek tense is not, that's the end of the game. It means, now it's ready to start. if you make a sword, you're forging a sword, it's finished. Now, of course, being finished, it's ready to be put to use. This is your commencement. And it just means get ready because you're about to start. What you start at, I don't know, and that's up to you. Because also at the root of that word is, as I said, the word initiate. Right? And of course, maybe you're being initiated into something new here today. You've taken certain steps in this initiation process, all those courses, and now we are here together to recognize the degree of your membership in the academic community. Those are all those words. I'm sorry to give this an English class, but what do you expect? We don't know how to do much else. Now I'm going to put it all together and see if we make any sense of it, or what we're doing here today, and what your education has meant, and so on. The curriculum, the course you followed, the race you ran through all those months and years. And it wasn't a random race. It was a course designed by experts to guide your race in certain ways, so that it would be a good race, a race that gets you somewhere in the end. All those grades, which mark your progress up the steps towards this achievement. The grade, then, is not a reward for some work you did. Hey, Professor, I did all the homework, now give me an A. No, it's not that. It's an indication of where you are, which step the work you've done has taken you to. Graduation, the final step, the special step, the top of the flight of stairs. Maybe we can picture a long flight of stairs, and you've been going up these steps, different grades, first grade, second grade, you began all the way back there. All the way to the top, you have a special landing now, and now you look around. I've made the grade, little engine that could. That's who you are today. That's the guarantee. Little engine that could, commencement. The degrees of the process. And those are the different landings, the flight of stairs. The associate is the apprentice, working your way up. The bachelor, the young knight, still a novice in arms, but in arms nevertheless. The master, we can go off on your own and pass it all on to others.
So you love me.
Commencement. You're finished. Sword, you're now ready to put to use. The initiation. I want to stop a minute to think about your initiation into this degree. I know it from the teacher's point of view, but I see all that the students go through as well. Especially teaching English, but I'm always writing papers to say how tough it is to get the paper done. Let's recognize all you went through in the initiation process. All those papers and tests, late nights, disappointments, nerve-wracking presentations in front of the class, struggles to get to class even after 12 exhausting hours at work, and a slow tractor on the road at Clopton just when you're late for class. Or the traffic jam on the A14 when you're doing that long run over to Lake Deacon Morgan Hall in classes there. The missed meals, or the meals taken at the back of the classroom, or as you're driving home from class. How many people have stained on the seat next to the driver's seat? Not to mention all the time that they take away from the family and the sacrifices they make to help you reach this point. All this dedication, and dedication, by the way, means giving of yourself. All of this took dedication. You came this far. It's the great step in the course of becoming an educated man or woman. So, this is your commencement.
Go off now and do your stuff. You have your badge, your rank, your degree, which of course is not only an honor and a reward to you, it's an obligation to use your education to serve others. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The efforts and accomplishments of our graduates. Would Colonel Smith and Mrs. Spears please come forward and present the degrees? Those with cameras, please feel free to come forward and take pictures. Thank you.
Scott C. Ashley, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Criminal Justice. A. Bates, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Communications, Applications, Technology. Michael C. Brown, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Information Systems, Technology. Douglas C. Cameron, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Vehicle Maintenance. Danielle D. Houston, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Construction Technology. Andy W. Lester, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Information Systems Technology. Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science and Avionics Systems Technology and Information Systems Management. Catherine K. Mateo, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science Maintenance Production Management. Judy D. Nichols, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science Munition Systems Technology. Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science and Logistics. Joe F. Stout, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Computer Science Technology. Monique Williams, Community College of the Air Force, Associate in Applied Science, Communications Applications Technology. Stanley G. Rowan, University of Maryland, University College, Associates of Arts, General Curriculum. Colin C. Smith, University of Maryland, University College, Associates of Arts, General Curriculum. James W. Atkinson III, University of Maryland, University College, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. University of Maryland, University College, Bachelor of Science, Psychology. Monica C. Bear, University of Maryland, University College, Bachelor of Science, Psychology. Thomas L. Murray, University of Maryland, University College, Associates of Arts, Management Studies, and a Bachelor of Science, Information Systems Management. David L. Phillips, Boyd State University,
Master of Science, Management Information Systems. Thank you, Colonel Smith and Mrs. Spears. Degrees have been awarded. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2004 graduates. At
this point, it is my pleasure to invite Colonel Smith to address the graduates.
Well, first of all, I want to add my welcome to everybody. This is a special day, especially for the folks who are seated on this side of the hall, but we appreciate the folks in the Joint Analysis Center, like the National Chief, for joining us. Dr. Emerson, thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to offer some appropriate remarks. As somebody who gets to look at a lot of performance reports on a daily basis, I took to heart the message on the meaning of words, and there's probably a lot of people that wrote that reports that could benefit from your mentorship, I'm sure, on some of that. Certainly, those of you who've been out there and benefited from the work of people like Dr. Abramson appreciate that what you gained out of this hopefully meant a great deal. And it means a great deal to me. There's just three quick things I'd like you to take away. First of all, you ought to be proud of yourself because I recognize how busy all of you are, particularly the folks who are in the military. I mean, it's not just about doing your job, and you're taking time out of your busy schedules in the evenings and other times to pull this thing through. There's some other folks here who contribute a lot to that, the families, the dependents, and so forth, that were giving of their time and understanding and support in many ways, I'm sure, including maybe packing some of those dinners in a hasty fashion that ended up in the front seat of the car and other measures of support. That's important. But the one thing I'd like you to maybe walk away from is just one thing I can offer, particularly for the folks who are seated here in union, and that is, there's a reason, I submit to you, that we have the greatest military in the world that's able to accomplish many things in a very chaotic world, as kind of was mentioned here a little while ago. It's because of the quality of our people, particularly our enlisted force and our NCOs. And that's not me that's talking. All you've got to do is go out and talk to and engage some of the people that I've had an opportunity to speak with in some of my higher learning, at places like the Air War College, in the Army's Command and General Staff College. When you talk to people from other parts of the world who understand what it is we do and why we do it so well, it's because of the strength of our non-commissioned officer. Well, why do you suppose that is? Well, it's because people like you have committed yourselves to making the best that you can be. But you go out there and aren't satisfied with just getting by. You want to continually improve yourself. You want to know the most you can about particular fields that you're engaged in, but also in broadening yourself so that you, as you go up higher in rank and gain more responsibilities and must have a broader view of things and grasp a lot more than just what your initial specialty was. You have to be a critical thinker. And to get on without a lot of guidance from above. It doesn't take people like me or Colonel Kalisky or Colonel Ruffin to tell you what it is that you need to do because you've been able to figure it out on your own. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. That's why it is, and that's why what you've done here, in my view, is so very important, because it's going to keep us on the top and allow us to do the important thing to get out there and do what you know that you need. So I won't belabor the point too much more, because I guess I'm about one of the last things standing between you and some refreshments, and relaxing and stretching your legs. I know the kids are probably ready for the cake, right? So without further ado, thanks also to Hildegard and to Team Alkenberry in the Tri-Base area for hosting this wonderful ceremony. As some of you may recognize, it's not just Tri-Base folks who are here. There are others who travel other ways to get here. And we appreciate the fact that you're able to put this together in such a fine fashion. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Colonel Smith. At this time, I'd like to invite Senior Master Sergeant Robin Casper to share a final tribute to the graduating class and make a special presentation.
I'm pleased to be here today to help recognize an outstanding graduate of the Community College of the Air Force by awarding the Pitzenbarger Award, named after Airman First Class William H. Pitzenbarger, recipient of the Medal of Honor. For more than 40 years, the Aerospace Education Foundation, an affiliate of the Air Force Association, has been working to support the education goals of the Air Force family through various scholarships, awards, and fellowships across the nation. Many of the foundation's programs focus on promoting math and science in schools to prepare the next generation of young people for the technological challenges they will face. other programs encourage a national dialogue about aerospace issues for informed judgments about America's aerospace future. The ultimate goal is for all Americans to be knowledgeable of the issues and be supportive of their Air Force and its mission. The Pitts and Barber Award is at the heart of the efforts to encourage Air Force enlisted members to continue their education. Only through an education and a talented enlisted force can we assure America's aerospace excellence. We see the Pitts and Barber Award as just one more way to recognize outstanding educational achievements among the U.S. Air Force enlisted personnel, and to provide an incentive to continue their educational pursuits towards bachelor's degree. Colonel Felicity, please come forward, because nothing we can do is more important than supporting the Air Force enlisted professionals. And for that reason, the Aerospace Education Foundation and the Air Force Association are most pleased to present this check for $400 and a certificate of achievement to Airman First Class Gregory A. Bates, Imagery Analyst, Joint Analysis Center.
Don't do that.
What's
oh.
How
are
you doing here?
Oh, sorry, was that me for me to say we're here for Daddy's graduation? Yeah. Surprise!
Yeah.
Oh, right at his stomach.
It went that way. Is it done then?
Congratulations,
Congratulations!
Woo! Daddy got his master's degree today. Yay!
He won!
We won!
See the cake that his wife lovingly made him?
Yes, yes,
Congratulations, Dad.
Oh, thank you.
I'm so happy to see you guys all here today.
I've only got about 6 minutes left on this.
Can I have one of your donuts, Daddy?
This is one of my stomachs.
Lucky,
that's yours.
That's what you were talking about. Oh, that's really cool.
Oh, what? The car?
It says congratulations.
I wasn't putting two together.
Mommy.
Thank you.
That is really nice, guys.
Congratulations.
And celebrations. Oh, my windows look filthy.
That's good. I'm tired.
I will do second buddy things. Oh, I got to sit in the graduate's chair.
Yeah, you do.
Graduate.
The old
and I get to sit next to the donut.
And Matthew gets to sit next to the donut. Matt.
Oh my God.
Matt.
No.
Don't break anything.
Yeah, don't aim it towards it.
Yeah, get a glass. Close, ready.
Is it going to squirt?
Is it going to squirt?
Oh God.
It might.
God, he's going to break something.
No, do it outside.
Do it outside. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Daddy.
Everybody watching?
Oh no, you've got to stand outside.
Stand outside, sorry.
Oh God, didn't know we were doing it now.
Here, I'll come out here and do it.
No, do it where you were.
She doesn't want to go outside.
Take two.
Running it.
Oh God, I'm scared.
Go. Well, this is embarrassing for Daddy. Can't get the boss away. Oh, shall I do it, hon?
Here we go.
Mr. Olivia, no!
Yeah, that's not gonna go.
Look at Olivia's face, she's like...
I've only got 4 minutes left on this tape, Dave.
Oh my God!
It's good and chilled.
Oh, we're gonna send this...
Hey!
Woo! Dad, I
woo-hoo!
Don't know to
say woo-hoo! Woo-hoo!
Oh, God.
Oh, this? Yeah. Well, the compass.
Go.
Mama thinks I look pretty.
I love Daddy and he looks beautiful.
Oh, honey, that's lovely. I let you've already drank all your champagne.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just no, don't
do that. Just like this. Olivia, what would you like to say?
It looks funny in that hat.
Oh, what do you think of what Daddy did today? Was it really cool?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you understand what Daddy did today?
It was really cool.
Olivia.
Yeah.
And that's before champagne. I think you take that champagne off of her. And to the most...
Ugly girl.
Perfect girl.
Ugly girl.
Daddy's dropping his champagne. He hasn't even had a drink yet.
Well, I'm proud of Daddy's robe colour because that's my house colour. Woo, go Daltons. well done, Daddy.
Yeah.
Take it back your way. No. Your way first.
Oh God, no!
Take it back to me.
Can you see me?
Yes.
I just wanted to say congratulations to you, Dave. I love you very much. You've done a fabulous job over the last 15 years, and hopefully your PhD won't take that long.
Oh.
Love you.
Oh, can you just take a film of me? No, just one more bit. I love Daddy.
Oh, that's nice. Sit down, you drunk.
Oh, thanks, honey. Behind every behind every good man, moi, is a good woman. Moi.
Aww.
Cheers, everybody.
No, you don't say-